Good evening, sports fans, and welcome inside Montpetit Hall. Bienvenue and welcome. We are set for another OUA game between the Ottawa GGs and the Ryerson Rams. Those number 8 ranked Ottawa GGs, if you were with us last night, fell short in an effort against the Toronto Varsity Blues, dropping the Ryerson is moving the ball quite effectively right now. That is Chloe Mangle with it in her hands. Three-pointer fired up by Silvana Jens. She missed. Here comes Julia Soriano. Soriano trying to work it down to Tilk. Not going to get it there. Missed to Maddie Stevens and picked up by Francesca Bellumer-Moya. She's in the starting lineup tonight as Catherine Traer is sitting on the bench with a cast or a soft wrap on her left, on her right wrist that she hurt early in the game last night. Zangela Tilk goes up and in for two. I wasn't able to get an injury update on Catherine Traer, but she's not dressed for the game, so the team will be without her for tonight and foreseeably for Tuesday's game against Carleton, which we'll talk about more later. That was Annie Sokoloff for two. Little 10-foot jumper goes for her. So, starting for your GGs tonight, the number 8 ranked GGs, number 3, Julia Soriano, number 9, Francesca Bellumer-Moya, Maddie Steven, number 10, who has the ball stripped away, Stephanie McDonald, number 5, who had a tough night shooting last night, and Angela Tilk, number 14, who had a double-double in that last night's loss. Ball is wrestled for on the floor, and Ryerson eventually comes up with it and resets. Gabriel Robinson kicks it down to Sokoloff, who now has it in her hands. That's Gabriel Robinson again. Stolen! Here comes Tilk, gets it ahead to Bellumer-Moya. She goes up with the left and scores. Bellumer-Moya didn't play last night, so she should have fresh legs for this game. She's going to need it to replace the effort that Catherine Traer usually puts forward for this team. So, Gabriel Robinson has it. Now it's in the hands of Mariah Nunes. She crosses over, gets in the lane, left hand, just off the rim, no good. Gets her own rebound, tries to kick it out. Ball's being fought for. It's on the ground. Stephanie McDonald has it. Gets it to Maddie Steven. Julia Soriano has it now. 2-on-3. Nice feed. But Bellumer-Moya thinks better. Tilk gets it. Cutting through the middle. She was the trailer. Fouled, and she'll go to the line. So Bellumer-Moya will be asked to fill in for Catherine Traer. And her 8 points and 24 minutes a game. So that's a big task for someone off the bench to come in and fill, but Bellumer-Moya will give it her best shot tonight. Tilk missed the first one. Ryerson comes in here after last night's game, in which they only lost by 2 to number 1 ranked Carleton in a thrilling game that saw plenty of lead changes, and Ryerson put themselves on the map with that game, even if it was a loss. That was Mariah Nunes driving. Gets the foul, and she'll shoot 2 free throws. So the GGs were only able to muster 16 second-half points last night, which is a season low. I think we can all agree that that's to be expected. So this is Nunes with her first, and they'll try it. They haven't been a team that, you know, stinks it up 2 nights in a row too often. They're a very veteran team, and they get this might be the perfect situation for them tonight, as Ryerson is the worst-ranked defense in the league in the OUA. So a chance for the GGs to score some serious points and get their confidence back going into a tough game Tuesday night. Bellumer-Moya has it on the close wing, gets the screen from Maddie Steven, kicks out Stephanie. She's going to fire it up way off. So we'll see if her shooting gets better. I watched her closely in warm-ups. She was making lots. Rebound secured by the GGs off the turnover. Gets it down low to Tilk. She's rocking a headband tonight. Nice little step through for two. So the second leading scorer on the GG squad gets herself off to a good start. This is Gabrielle Robinson. Now Nunes has it. Up, no good. Rebounded by Tilk and into the hands of Soriano. Belly Marmoy up for three. And it's a 6-point GG's lead with that three. So this is Gabrielle Robinson. That's her whole last name, not her full name, just so you guys are aware. Her any GG's fans. Crossover by Yez. Up, no good. Rebounded by Gabrielle Robinson. Out to Mago. She's going to dribble around. She's got to shoot it, put it up. No time on the clock. Rebounded by Tilk. She's fouled by Sokolov. And it'll be GG's ball going the other way. Ryerson very good at keeping their players fresh. They have, what does my notes say, 11 players averaging between 13 and 15 minutes, so they'll keep it fresh. They just brought three subs in. Number 7, Kaneka Pingills, who was last night's leading scorer over at Carleton with 17 points. And number 15, Sky Johns is in, as well as, hold on a second while I identify, number 5, Julia Robertson. And the GGs have Charlotte McKenzie checked back in. It's her second game back with the GGs. Soriano's going to have to put it up. Gets it hit away. And they're going to call that the first 24-second shot clock violation of the night. So 10 points on the boards for the GGs, but still some offensive issues to work through. They had 4 or 5 of those 24-second shot clock violations in the second half last night. So here is Pingills. Goes baseline. Tough move. Nicely done by Ping Giles. That's her first 2 points of the game. Ping Giles, my mistake. McDonald brings the ball up the court. Gives it to Bellumere. And it will stay with the GGs. That is knocked away by Julia Robertson. Last night was the first time. Nice move by Angela Tilk. No good. Now I'll finish my thought. Last night was the first time the GG's been held under 50 points this season. So they'll look for a great offensive showing, and this might be the defense to go. It's Pink Giles for three. No good. Quick release for her. Couldn't get it to go. Tilk with the rebound, and quickly into the front court comes Stephanie McDonald. Hands it off to Bellumere Moya. She's looking for a lane, but instead she slips it to Charlotte McKenzie, who can't hold it. Tilk grabbed it, but she dribbled on the end line, and out it goes. Here comes Danielle Marion, the GG's female athlete of the week. She'll be charged, it looks like, with guarding Ping Giles. Ping Giles in the corner. Looks to shoot. She looks like she wants the shot. She's going to handle. Working these girls right now. Bumped by Charlotte McKenzie. And that's the team's second foul of the quarter. In comes Sarah Besslink for Julia Soriano, which will move Stephanie McDonald to the point. Inbounding the ball. That's a 5-second violation. That was Mariah Nunes who couldn't get the ball in. And the GGs will take over. Charlotte McKenzie will inbound, and we have some full court pressure being applied, it looks like. So here's Stephanie McDonald. Let's see if she can get back into her scoring groove. Get back to her 17 points a game feel that we've had for her. Just on cue, she makes me look good and scores two. 12-6 now for the GGs. Robertson. To Gabrielle Robinson. Robertson, shot fake. They're going to call her on a walk. Well, if you watched last night, the GGs had about 13 of those called against them last night in the second half, so they sure know it on the bench when they saw it. Angela Took's going to get a breather as Maddie Steven comes back in. Here's Stephanie McDonald, nice crossover. Handling around, gets a GG on the, or gets a ram on the floor. Charlotte McKenzie goes up, off the glass, countered, and the foul. Foul will go on Sky Johns. That's the team's third team foul of the quarter, her first. And here come more of the Ryerson Rams as Mariah Nunes gets a break and Charlotte McKenzie makes that one. They're going to call another walk on the Rams, this time on Ping Giles. Stephanie has it poked away by Gabrielle Robinson. Feeds it ahead to McKenzie. McKenzie goes baseline, flips it to Steven. Up and good. Five quick ones in a row rolled off by the GGs. It's now 17-6. Robertson has it out high now after Nunes or Gabrielle Robinson tried to work the post. Stepped out on by Charlotte McKenzie. Here's Nunes again. Excuse me. Gabrielle Robinson stolen by McDonald. Picked up by Steven. And Stephanie McDonald calls the ball at the floor. Marion wide open for three off the front rim, but gets her own rebound. Brings it out the other side. Puts up a long two this time off the front rim. Rebound Maddie Steven. And Stephanie McDonald asks for the clear out. Charlotte McKenzie gets it up at the top of high post. Danielle Marion has it. She's got to be careful she doesn't walk. Moving all kinds of feet there. McKenzie has it out high. Here's Stephanie McDonald now. Tries to go behind her back. Nowhere to go with it. Gets it to McKenzie, but she can't handle it on the low feed. And it's Robertson Ryerson's ball. Here comes Ping Giles. Spins back. Tries to get it to Robertson. Does. All kinds of trouble down low for the Rams right now. As Robertson brings it all the way out to reset. Looks like they're going to go through Ping Giles all night if they can. She gets it. That was a carry, but she gets into the paint. Misses and goes, and now goes the other way. That was a blatant carry. I don't know how that wasn't called. But Stephanie McDonald brings it up and gets it to Danielle Marion. Charlotte McKenzie sets the high screen. Tried to roll. Now she has it the other way. Nice slip. Maddie Steven had her sealed inside. Couldn't get it. Looked like she hurt her side on that one. Angela Tilk's going to check back in now. Ping Giles going to fire up a three. She had no... Stephanie McDonald's got to get a hand in her face. That girl can shoot. That was pure and smooth. So here comes the GGs now. It's in the hands of Sarah Bessling. Gets it to Charlotte McKenzie. Really trying to work that high-low game, but here comes Steph. McDonald gets it. Wide open is Marion. Off the front rim. Can't get it to fall. Bessling fights with Ping Giles for it, and we got a jump ball. We have a timeout by the Ryerson Rams head coach Carly Clark, and we'll take a short break. So we are back with 70 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Gigi's have a 17-9 lead and will inbound on the baseline. Sarah Beslink will get the ball in her hands. Gets it quickly to Angela Tilk to set up the play. Tilk goes baseline, met there by a double team. Knocked away and picked up by Ryerson. That was Silvana Yez that picked it up. Jeez, I got to get that one down. So you got to have your hand up in her face. She'll shoot that all night. Mariona victim there. Kaneka Ping-Giles with that one. And we have a foul on Julia Robertson. That's the team's fourth foul. 43 seconds to play. Gigi's will inbound. Julia Soriano back in the game will bring it up. Gets it to Sarah Beslink. Maddie Steven has it. In the hands of Marion. Tilk has it. Nowhere to go. Gets it to Soriano. All kinds of movement of the ball. Blocked by Sky Johns, but recovered by the Gigi's. Bessling's going to get another shot at it off the front rim and rebounded by Ping-Giles. And I bet you she'll shoot it at the end of this clock. Foul by Sarah Beslink. 17-12 is your score. So if my math is right, Ping-Giles has 8 of the 12 Ryerson Ram points to this point. So lock her down with a box in one or something there, coach. Because she's going to kill you all night if you let her shoot threes like this. That one's way off. She faded on it, though. Marion did a better job getting the ball in her hands, and Tilk's just going to hold it for the end of the first quarter. So that's the first quarter. Gigi's up 17-12, and we'll be right back. And we're back underway at Montpetit Hall. Have some first quarter stats for you in a second as Ryerson gets the ball moving around. Gabrielle Robinson has it now. Magot has it. Magot gets down low. No, excuse me, that was Nunes who tried to feed it down low to Gabrielle Robinson. And the pass was off the mark. So your first quarter scoring leaders, Ping-Giles has 8. And both Angela Tilk and Belly Marimoya have 5 apiece for the Gigi's. Gigi's shot 43% in that quarter. And Ryerson at 33%. Soriano off the mark on a 3. Magot tried to throw it off of Julia Soriano and it worked. So the ball will stay with the Ryerson Rams. Rebounding advantage goes to the Gigi's 9-7. GGs have three assists, which is more than they had in the first half last night, so that's a good sign if you're a GGs fan. Ryerson had seven turnovers, but the GGs had six, so a sloppy opening quarter. And that was almost another turnover as Mago forced it to Mariah Nunes. Here's Mago now. Throws up a wild shot. No good. Rebounded by Maddie Steven, and Julia Soriano's off to the races. Gets it to Marion. No good. Missed another layup. That killed the GGs last night. And back quickly come the Rams. This is Gabrielle Robinson. That is Silvana Yens. Yes. She's out on the line now. And that ball is thrown away off the hands of Sky Johns and out of bounds. Belly Mermoya coming in for Danielle Marion. So here comes Stephanie McDonald, being watched by Gabrielle Robinson. Maddie Steven tried to drop it into Angela Tilk, didn't work, and away come the Rams. So that's two turnovers for the GGs so far in the quarter. Gabrielle Robinson has it. Nope, excuse that, Mariah Nunes. Nunes gets the jumper up, gets it to go. 3-point lead for the GGs. GGs hit two of their three free throws in the opening quarter. The only one missed was by Stephanie McDonald. We got an offensive foul on the GGs. Maddie Steven 10 on the illegal screen. No other real notable stats. No big foul trouble for either team through a quarter, which is to be expected. But Ping Giles has six shots taken for the GGs, for the Rams. The next closest person has taken two. So the offense runs through her if you're Ryerson. Another missed shot for the Rams, and here comes Julia Soriano. Right through the paint she goes, kicks it out to Stephanie McDonald, who fakes and goes baseline. Comes back up to the top, wide open. She'll fire that up. No good. Rebounded by Mago, and away she goes. Mago waiting for something to set up. Yez has it, gives it to Nunes. Nunes in the paint, puts up the jumper, no good. Rebounded by Tilk. And Julia Soriano goes away again. GGs are really trying to work the high-low game tonight. Nice turnaround, fadeaway jumper by Angela Tilk. Angela Tilk picks up the foul. Sorry, folks, my computer decided to do some updates, so I had to reboot it quickly. I'm back now. Pink Giles back in the game, so watch for her to continue her hot scoring. Charlotte McKenzie back in for the GGs, as is Sarah Beslink. Julia Robertson has also checked back into the game for the Rams, as has Annie Sokoloff. This is Nunes. Scratch that, Gabrielle Robinson. No, it was Nunes. Nunes drives and dishes for two to Annie Sokoloff. It's a dime for Nunes. My mistake. Charlotte McKenzie kicks it over to Belly Mermoya. Now Soriano has it. Beslink has it. Ball is all over the place, and it'll stay with the GGs. Great defense being played by Ryerson. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Beslink inbound. Tilk has it in the post against Sokoloff. Gets it to go. So it looks like the offense might run through Tilk tonight. She's got it going early and often right now. Robertson into the hands of Ping Giles. They're going to try and get run her through 10 screens if they can. She'll fire that up all day. In and out. One-handed rebound by Angela Tilk. She fires it to Bellimer Moya, who had to stop and feed it over to Soriano. So Julia gets it down, gets it to Charlotte McKenzie. Bellimer Moya wide open for three. Off the rim, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Sokoloff and brought up by Julia Soriano. Nunes has it now. Floats, no good. Threw it up. She prayer was not answered. And here comes Bellimer Moya. Takes the 12-footer, gets it to go. Her seventh point of the games. Julia Robertson methodically brings the ball up the court. Into the hands of Sylvana Jens. Foul on the play. Sarah Bessling's going to take it. Nope. Angela Tilk going to take it. She's asking what she did wrong. She's not entirely sure. And she's going to take a seat after that. Looks like Stephanie McDonald checking back in. Julia Soriano's going to take a breather. Gabrielle Robinson is going to check in. Into the hands of Sylvana Yez. She goes baseline on Bellimer Moya. Spins, can't get it to go. Fights for her own rebound. On the floor. Bessling had it, tried to get it to her teammate, and it was knocked out of bounds by Annie Sokoloff. Stephanie McDonald hollers out the play as she brings it up the court. Being guarded by the smaller Julia Robertson. She squirts through the double team, throws it up, can't get it to go. Fights for the rebound. She gets it. Almost gets the fell out of bounds, but held it. Charlotte McKenzie tries to get it down to Maddie Steven. And there will be a reach-in foul on Sylvana Yez. Charlotte McKenzie gets the inbound pass, throws it up, and is fouled. This time by Annie Sokoloff. So Charlotte will shoot her first free throw of the night. Gets it to go. Sky John set to check back in for Ryerson. McKenzie's second free throw. Good. And here comes Sky John. Here comes Julia Robertson. Ping Giles waits patiently for the ball at the top of the key. She decides to go through. It's in the hands of Sierra Gabrielle Robinson. Nope, Ping Giles has it now. Way too easy. She made that look so smooth. Little spin. Left hand, good. And she goes to the line. Hoop in the harm, they call that one. Fouls on Bellimer Moya. It's four team fouls for the Gigi's with 4 minutes to play. Giles gets the rebound, or gets the free throw to go. And it's a 6-point game, 25-19, the Gigi's lead. Bellimer Moya wasn't sure where to go with it. Stephanie McDonald now has it. Kicks it out to Bessling. Bessling's going to get called for the travel, and the ball will go the other way. Charlotte McKenzie trying to get her team going. A little enthusiasm. Looks like Charlotte's just got the assignment from... Oh, we got a foul on Stephanie McDonald. That'll be the fifth team foul, or a football, which was the call. Football. During that last defensive setup, Andy Sparks told Charlotte McKenzie to get on Ping Giles and not to leave her alone. So Andy Sparks realizes who this offense runs through, and he's not going to let anything happen now. Charlotte McKenzie's going to put her to work, but Ping Giles is just so quick. So far tonight, we've seen her hit two fluid threes, and she just made Charlotte McKenzie look silly in the post. So her game is what you would call complete out there, folks. Bessling for three. That's the answer the team needed. 7-point lead restored for the Gigi's. And we have our second three of the game for the GGs. Robertson gets it. Let's see if they work. Now Maddie Steven is on Ping Giles. So let's see if that works out. Well, now they tried to go back door to Sierra Gabrielle Robinson. That didn't work. Stephen McDonald in the corner for three. Bang! Back-to-back threes for the GGs. Double-digit lead and timeout on the floor. We'll be back after the timeout. And we are back underway. Ryerson inbounds, stuck 10 after back-to-back threes from Sarah Beslink and Stephanie McDonald. Ryerson tries to go backdoor again to Nunes. Didn't work this time. And Ottawa will inbound. Stephanie McDonald has it. Charlotte McKenzie has it. Trying to beat that press. They get through it into the front court. And Belly Mermoya has it. Stephanie McDonald. They won't let her get free for another three, methinks. Stolen by Julia Robertson. And they're going to call a foul on Stephanie McDonald. That'll be the team's fifth. And Robertson will get a couple free throws. So, Julia Robertson will get a couple free throws here. And Julia Soriano will check into the game. Steph is so distracted by discussing with the ref that she didn't see Julia check in. Robertson, left-hand jumper, no good. I'm a lefty, but even when I watch left-handed people shoot free throws, it still looks like the strangest thing in the world to me. So she made 1 of 2, and Robertson will now quickly advance the ball up the court. 2 minutes to go in the opening half. Maddie Steven had nice low post position. Gets through for two. Julia Soriano almost came up with a steal up that inbound. 11-point lead for the GGs. Gabrielle Robinson had a lane. No one there in the help. Excuse me, that's Mariah Nunes. Her 6th point of the game. Maybe in the second half I'll get those two sorted out. We'll see. Charlotte McKenzie has it. Belly Mermoya now. Guarded by Gabrielle Robinson. Hit the side of the backboard. And it goes off a Ryerson player out of bounds. GG's ball. Coach Carly Clark all over her defensive players right now. Belly Mermoya trying to get it to Maddie. Steven does. Maddie has nice post position. That was a walk. Got away with it. Two more for the GGs. Julia Robertson has it. Now it's in the hands of Nunes. Nunes puts it up. No good. Ping Giles tried to rebound it. Looked like it went off of her, but it actually went off the GGs, and it'll stay white ball. So inbound play now. Nunes to inbound. Got to get it in eventually. I don't know where she was throwing that. might not be the one you want down there. That's a turnover, two turnovers for her while she's throwing that inbounds pass. Charlotte McKenzie now has it. Ooh, thought she was going to hand it off. No, she doesn't. Gets it to go. Alert play by Charlotte. She saw the D go with Bestlink, and she decided, ah, it's my turn. So this is Nunes now. Pingiles has it. Three, no good. Hit the front of the rim and rebounded by Charlotte McKenzie. 40 seconds to play in the opening half. And they're going to call a foul on Julia Robertson. I almost called her Julia Roberts, but I'm sure she would prefer Robertson. Bestlink will inbound, guarded by Nunes. 12 guarding 12. Oh, we got a foul on Sky Johns away from the ball as she was fighting with Maddie Steven. Be the team's fourth foul. Chloe McGough about to check in for Ryerson. And it's into the hands of Belly Mermoya, who catches it out of bounds. And the ball goes to Ryerson. So we've got 38 seconds to play. Probably good for two more shots to throw. We'll see what happens, though. McGough has it. They're going to work it down low to Pingiles. She is just way too good. Gets it out to McGough. McGough puts up the floater. No good. Rebound Maddie Steven. 20 seconds to go. Shot clock is off. We'll see if the GGs hold for the final. Yep. Andy Sparks yelling, last shot. So we'll see what they run. Poked away from Julia Soriano. Jump ball favors the GGs. 6 seconds to play. Good D being put on there by the Rams. And Coach Andy Sparks will call a timeout to draw up the play he wants to run with 6 seconds to go. We'll take a short timeout and be right back. And we are back. 6 seconds to play. Gigi's lead by 13. 37-24. Stephanie McDonald probably just going to put up a three, you'd think. She does. Almost gets it to go. No good. Halftime at Montpetit Hall. I'll have halftime stats for you after the break. But until then, enjoy your 15 minutes without my voice in your ear. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back for the second half. Gigi's are already on the floor, and Ryerson will join them shortly. A little first half stat recap for you. Ryerson is 9 of 26 from the floor, shooting 34.6%. The Gigi's are 48% from the floor, shooting 15 of 31. Gigi's have 6 assists on their 15 field goals. Ryerson has 2 on 9. The big stat sticking out for me with Ryerson, they have 12 turnovers already in the first half. As Nunes gets it to Sokolov. Nice ball fake. Can't get the shot to go. Belimir Moya goes away with it. Stops and gets it to Stephanie McDonald. Down low to Angela Tilk. Tilk works. Nowhere to go. Tries the hook. No good. Rebounded Stephanie McDonald. Steph goes up strong off the backboard. Good for two. Leading scorers at the half were Kaneka Pingills. She had 13 of Ryerson's 24 points. And Angela Tilk led the way for the GGs with 9. She also had 6 rebounds. So we'll put her on double-double watch as this game goes along. Gabriel Robinson up. No good. Rebounded by Sokolov. No foul called there. Here's Mago. Mago sets it back up. 19 on the shot clock. Gabriel Robinson gets it down to Yez. Yez can't get it to go. Rebounded by Sokolov. Another shot clock for the GG for the Rams. And away goes Mago. Nobody really moving on the floor for Ryerson. Looks like a two-man game right now. This is Nunes. Gets it to Mago as she came off a screen open. No good. Tilk pushed her man all the way out to the three-point line before collecting that rebound. Then she goes coast to coast and subsequently loses the ball. Well, can't say she's not an effort player, but sometimes you got to gear it down a little bit. So, here's Mago. Gets it into the hands of Nunes. Yez has it now into the hands of Gabrielle Robinson. Nunes has it. That's going to be, are they going to call a walk or an offensive foul? Offensive foul. Gigi's ball. The refs are still talking about it. We'll see what they call. So Nunes picks up the foul. Her first of the game. See, even the scoreboard clock guys are here screwing up. 9 and 12. They have 12 up on the board, but it was 9's foul. So anyone giving me grief, it's confusing. Stephanie McDonald goes hard to the rim. No good. Tilk with the board. Up and in. Good to go. More high effort out of Angela Tilk. Here's Gabrielle Robinson. Now into Mago's hands on the pass from Yez. Nunes has it now. That's Yez for three way off. Rebounded by Sokolov. Into Mago's hands, down low off the backboard. That was an alley-oop type pass. Mago will keep it. They got a reset on that. They probably shouldn't have. Nunes has it, gives it to Sokolov. Mago has it. Good low post position for Yez on Belimir Moya. And that's two for her. So Belimir Moya has it against Mago now. Maddie Steven into the corner for Stephanie McDonald. Not a great ball fake by Stephanie as she went for the two. Pulled up way short on the jumper. And away comes Ryerson. Really got to sell that ball fake if you're going to do that kind of thing. And she didn't on that one. So now Nunes has it. Mago, Sokolov working short corner. Foul on Maddie Steven. She's going to get called for the push. And that'll be the first foul on Ottawa in this quarter. Angela Tilk's going to get a little breather as Charlotte McKenzie comes in. Inbounded. That's Nunes for two. Doesn't get it to go. Rebounded by Belimir Moya. tries to get it up to Stephanie McDonald, and she does. Here's Belly Mermoya. Goes left, jump shot. Nope, she passed it down to Maddie Steven. Nice find, Belly Mermoya. Nice finish, Maddie Steven. Kaneka Pingill set to check in for Ryerson as Nunes misses the shot. She's had two shots in a row right at that spot and hasn't hit either of them. So here's Charlotte McKenzie working down low. Bella Moya playing the two-man game. That's a three. 20-point lead for the GGs. And Bella Moya filling in nicely for Catherine Traer. That's her 10th point of the game. She's hit 2 3-pointers and played some great defense out there. More great defense by the GGs. They come away with a steal. Here's Belly Mermoya. Feeds to Charlotte McKenzie. It's got a smaller Mago on her, but it's going to go down to Maddie Steven. She's guarded by Nunes. She's going to pick up the foul, and the GGs have all the momentum in the start of the second half. And Coach Carly Clark knows it. She's going to call timeout. Ryerson will take their first one of the half, and we'll be right back. And we are back. 5:23 to play as Maddie Stevens is going to shoot her first free throw. So we're back rather anticlimactically, to be honest. Hits the first. And the second one is up and through. Angela Tilk's going to check in for Maddie Steven. Julia Soriano guards Julia Robertson. And they're going to get an offensive foul on Julia Robertson. Her dad sitting right in front of us, big fan of that play. That's the third foul on Julia Robertson, so Coach Carly Clark's going to have a decision to make on that one. Stephanie McDonald goes straight right. No one there, and the GGs are starting to pull away. 50-26 is your margin right now. That's number 10, Diana Getchkova. Her first shot of the game doesn't go. Native of Sofia, Bulgaria. Shot goes up and off the top of the backboard. That's usually an out-of-bounds play, but not in OUA basketball. Here comes Peak Yields, but that is Getchkova. No good. And away come the GGs. Getchkova had a look there, but couldn't get it to fall. Here's Stephanie McDonald now. Tried the screen and roll with Charlotte McKenzie, but Pingills was there. That's a mouthful. Soriano for three, no good. Rebounded by Pingills. She's going to try and find She did find Gabrielle Robinson way up the court. Gechkova wide open for two. Bang, she gets it. Her first two of the game. Stephanie McDonald kicks it out into the corner. Charlotte McKenzie has it now off the pass from Danielle Marion. Kennedy's good goal, but look who's down there. Hoop and harm for Angela Tilk. Two more, and she'll go to the line to shoot a free throw. So Coach Carly Clark, to make it easy on me, takes Gabrielle Robinson out and puts Mariah Noons in. So that'll make my life a lot easier. I shouldn't screw that one up for at least a couple minutes. So here's Gechkova working. She gets it in to Sokolov, who's fouled immediately by Angela Tilk. I think that's Angela's second, might be her third. Third foul for Angela Tilk. Really trying to get it to Ping Gills, but instead it'll go to Sokolov and now to Julia Robertson. Robertson drives left, throws it up wildly, gets it to go. Ryerson's going to need a lot more buckets if they're going to get back in this game. They trail 53-30 right now with 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. So here's Charlotte McKenzie with it in her hands, trying to get it to Angela Tilk. Nice look to Stephanie McDonald. Can't get it to fall. Late whistle. Gigi's will shoot two. There's one weakness on this Gigi's team. It might be those entry passes to the low post. They try to do it sometimes too quickly. For a veteran team, they need to show more patience, especially as the season winds down and we get towards playoffs and the CIS championships. Stephanie McDonald gets the first one to go. And the second one is no good, rebounded by Pingills. So away and running go the Rams. Julia Robertson comes up with a head of steam and sets up the play. Pingills wide open. She'll fire that, and she does, and she misses. So after hitting a couple early threes, she's really gone cold. Gechkova's going to get called on a silly foul. She was in poor position to be going after the ball on that one. And already the GGs will shoot free throws. That's the 15 foul for the Rams. So Danielle Marion will take the free throws. First one goes. And second one goes. So here's Pingals now with the ball. Gechkova has it on the far wing. Working to get it down low to Pingals, but instead we're going to get a foul on Charlotte McKenzie after Angela Tilk gets the steal. In football, we would call that pass interference, but in basketball, it's a foul. Pingiles gets it to Noons now. Gechkova has it. Long three. Lots of range for her. No good. Rebounded by Pingiles. Oh, they're going to call an offensive foul on Pingiles. She doesn't like it, and her team has to kind of back her away there. Carly Clark doesn't like that call. She's got to be careful right now. Ping Giles picks up her first foul. She hasn't scored in the second half. Charlotte McKenzie, they're really trying to work that high-low post game instead. Beslink open in the corner for three. Hits the back rim, doesn't get it to go. Got a foul. Foul or out of bounds on the GGs? Out of bounds by Ryerson. Don't know what they saw down there, but my view was blocked from up here, so Gigi's will inbound the full shot clock. Besselink steps out of bounds on her pivot foot. not aware of where she was on the court. And some say the ball never lies, so Ryerson will take over. Here's Julia Robertson playing with three personal fouls. Screen set by Sky Johns. She's trying to slip. They get it to Gechkova, who drives baseline, goes up and in for two. Help wasn't there. Defense rotated late, and that's two for Gechkova. Stephanie McDonald drives up, gives it to Marion. Marion crosses over, back to McDonald. Pull-up jumper, good. Two more for Stephanie McDonald. Pingyle's leaking out. Can't handle the pass, though. Still has it. Probably had an easy look at two if she handles that cleanly. But instead, here they go again. Oh, Julia Robertson and Sky John's not on the same page. Nunes goes back door, but they can't find her. And it'll be a turnover. Another one for Ryerson. So, coming back in, Danielle, Maddie Steven, and Julia Roberts. Julia Soriano checking in. Keeping those four and fives fresh are the GGs tonight, as they only have three with Catherine Traer being out. So apt time for Charlotte McKenzie to come back. Soriano looking the wrong way. Pingills goes up, fouled. She'll go to the line for two. Julia Soriano a little out of position on that two-on-one, looking the wrong way. Got to know that Pingills is a scorer and will look to score on that every time. She gets the first one to go. Second one hits the front of the rim and goes through. Julia Soriano has it, bringing it up. Now Charlotte McKenzie gets it to Sarah Bessling. She's double-teamed there. Gets out of it. And now back in the hands of Julia Soriano. Marion has it. High-low game again for the GGs. Stripped by Sky Johns is Maddie Steven. And away comes Gechkova off a weird exchange. Sky Johns couldn't handle the pass from Julia Robertson. They have a foul. Looks to be on the GGs. Nope, that'll be on Sky Johns. So back down the other way we'll go now for two shots. And it'll be Sarah Bessling shooting the free throws.
Two shots for Sarah Bessling.
No good on the first is Sarah Bessling. Take this time to remind you that Tuesday is the next GG's home game. Technically a home game, but on a neutral site. They'll play Carleton at Canadian Tire Center in the annual Capitol Hills game, as Bessling missed the second free throw, but the GGs picked it up, and another GG will go to the foul line. This time it'll be Charlotte McKenzie. So the GGs will go into that game against Carleton, barring tonight's results, stuck one game in the standings. In the OUA East, McKenzie goes up with the first and hits it. Don't know if they'll have Catherine Traer back for that game, but Carleton is a very balanced team, and they'll have their hands full. But you'll hear me on the mic Tuesday. If you've had enough of me, just hit mute. I won't feel bad. I'll never know. But I'll be there. I hope you will be too. Here's Gechkova. Looks like we're going to get another charge. That's three drawn by the GGs tonight. Angela Tilk really loved that one. That was Charlotte McKenzie. Gechkova picks up her second foul of the quarter. We have 20 seconds left to play. I don't know where that third quarter went. That was quick. That was a soft attempt at a double team. Didn't really work. And Charlotte McKenzie will inbound in the backcourt. Here's Soriano, guarded closely by Robertson. Stolen by Robertson. Thrown up over the head of Nunes. Tried to save it, couldn't, and it'll go back Gigi's way. Tried to throw it off of Danielle Marion, but never could quite get a handle on it, and almost threw it in the camera guy's face. 1 second left, and Soriano will just dribble it out. So So the Gigi's able to pull away in that third quarter. Score is 60-34. We'll come back with the final 10 minutes after a short interlude. And we are back underway for the final quarter. Stats coming up right now, which I perceived to drop, so hang on. Stephanie McDonald will inbound the ball to start. Let's go over some stats as the Gigi's get this possession going. Belly Mermoya off for three. Tilk almost gets it, does save it. Can Stephanie get to it? Nope. And Ryerson will get it. So only four turnovers in the quarter for Ryerson, giving them 16 and a half during the game. Gigi's have 13 turnovers of their own. Nine assists on their 26 made field goals, 22 made field goals. Five on Ryerson's 13 made field goals. Gigi's shooting 47%, so up in that quarter. Foul on Maddie Steven, as Ping Giles will go to the line and shoot two. Ryerson down in the third quarter, bringing their total to 31%. Kanika Ping Giles only able to muster 2 points in that quarter. She still has 15, and your leading score. Four Gigi's in double figures. Stephanie McDonald has 12. Belly Mermoya and Maddie Steven have 10 apiece, and your leading scorer for the Gigi's is Angela Tilk with 14. Ping Giles misses both the second free throw, apologies. And up she comes, Belly Mermoya. Ball fake, no good. Maddie Steven. Tilk has it now. Ball fakes. Passes it off to Maddie Steven. Gets her post position back. Tried to flop by Sky Johns. Doesn't work. Misses, but a foul, and she'll go to the line. Angela Tilk also has 9 boards, so on her way to another triple-double. Foul is on Sierra Gabriel Robinson. She's got 3. I don't think that foul is on Gabriel Robinson, unless the numbers they're given are different than what I have. Let me check. Oh, I've had it wrong the whole game, apparently, but the roster I was given has it differently. Nope, I have it right. Gabriel Robinson picks up her third foul. Up and in goes Ping Giles. So that's 7 for her. Sorry, 18 for her. All kinds of bodies falling on the floor right now. And Ryerson will inbound. So Ping Giles has all 3 points for Ryerson in the quarter. Gabriel Robinson has it. Robertson has it now. She goes behind her back. Trying to find something. Falls. Keeps her footing. Sokolov has it. Up. Off front of rim. No good. Rebounded by Angela Tilk. There's her double-double. So two in consecutive nights for her. And Beslink wide open for three. Looked good. Little short. Can't get her own rebound. And the ball will go back to Ryerson. Charlotte McKenzie checking in. Julia Robertson and her three fouls bring the ball up the court. Getchkova has it now. Gives it to Sokolov. And now there's Gabriel Robinson. Gabriel Robinson gives it to Robertson. She's open for three. Missed it. Stays with the Rams. Mariah Noons into the game now. Now Gabrielle Robinson has it in the corner, brings it into the paint, goes up, gets the roll. Nope, rebounded by Charlotte McKenzie. Stephanie McDonald will bring it up, calls out the play, and she's guarded by Gabrielle Robinson. Ooh, big screen set there by Charlotte McKenzie. Beslink has it now. Sarah dribbles around, tries to find somebody, gets it down low to Tilk. Looked like a receiver diving for a pass. It's two football references for y'all, those of you out there counting. Speaking of which, I have the Niners and Broncos winning tomorrow. If you don't care, I apologize. Charlotte McKenzie now. Gives it to Tilk. Tilk's going to have to put it up. She's going to get called. No, we got a blocking foul on Sokolov. And it will be on the floor foul. So the GGs will get a 14-second on the shot clock. And away we go. Somebody's got to get open for Beslink. That was Charlotte McKenzie. Big fadeaway. No good. Rebounded by Sokolov, and here comes Gabriel Johnson. Robinson gives it to Robertson. There's Pingiles. Pingiles ball fakes, gets into the paint. Up, hoop, and the harm. Say what you want about this Ryerson team, but that girl can score. Tilk's got four, so they got to be careful with her with still 7 minutes left in the game. Danielle Marion going to spell Sarah Beslink for a period here. And Pingiles hits the free throw. That's her sixth point of the quarter and 23rd of the game. 21st of the game, my mistake. So Ryerson forced a turnover there, and it will stay their ball. Steps out of bounds, though, does Julia Robertson, and it will go back to the GGs. And Julia Soriano has it poked out of her hands and pushed out of bounds when she dribbled into the double team. Charlotte McKenzie to inbound. Gets it to Soriano. She's working against Robertson. Stephanie McDonald tries to feed it down in the post to Maddie Steven, and it's knocked away by Annie Sokolov. So that was a prime example of what I was talking about in the third quarter, where the GGs need to be a little more patient on their inbounds passes to the post if they really want to be an effective team. Stephanie McDonald way off on her three. She is one of five from three from downtown this evening. Not her usual three-point shooting self. Or high-scoring self, for that matter, this weekend. Maddie Steven has it, but has it knocked away by Nunes. Saved by Marion. And turned over as Nunes stole it away. But now Charlotte McKenzie steals it right back. I can't keep up with this pace right now. Here's Stephanie McDonald. Gets it to McKenzie. Soriano wide open in the corner. No good. Can't get her own rebound. Ran past it. Two on one the other way. Not pretty, but it goes down for Mariah Nunes. We have a timeout. Looks like Coach Andy Sparks wants to talk to his team. As the lead is 19 for the Gigi's with 6:17 to play. We'll step out and be right back. Gigi's are currently shooting free throws for a technical foul that was assessed at the end of that timeout. Coach Carly Clark just gave it to the refs a little too much right as we went to break. And Stephanie McDonald missed both, so Coach Carly Clark's harsh words do not hurt her team. Bellimer Moya checks back in. Julia Soriano takes the inbounds pass, brings it up to Danielle Marion. Now Maddie Steven has it. See if they try and work high-low. Nope, Bellimer Moya is going to get it. Gigi's going to give Stephanie McDonald a little break, try and get her fresh for Tuesday. This is Mariah Nunes running the court, right up. In she goes. And it's a 17-point lead. Bellimer Moya has it now. Short wing here. Soriano now. Wild pass from Maddie Steven. Gets it to Bellimer Moya. Wild shot. She was going away from the rim and threw up a prayer. Somewhat answered as she'll go to the line and shoot a couple free throws. Chloe Magot going to check in here for Ryerson. Bellimer Moya makes the first. And hits the second. Pingiles for three. Nope, short again. Just hasn't had the range in the second, third, or fourth quarters. But has still managed to pour in 21 on the night. So Tilk gets it on the pass from Bellimer Moya. Skips it long to Danielle Marion, who wildly fires it up. Didn't have her feet set. Threw it up, no good. Here's Mariah Nunes, countered in the foul. Ryerson has been a fourth quarter team in their last two games, rallying in the fourth quarter from huge deficits. And I don't want to speak too soon, but it looks like they're starting to do the same to the Gigi's. This free throw will cut the lead back to 16, with 5 minutes to play in the quarter. So that's a 13-3 run to start the fourth quarter. And we'll see if the GG's scoring slump starts to creep. Scoring slump that affected them last night starts to creep into their minds a little bit as we come down the wire here. Here's Julia Soriano driving baseline. Has it knocked away by Sierra Gabriel Robinson. Gabriel Robinson, whatever you want to call her. There's Stephanie McDonald. They're going to call the offensive foul. Little bit of a flop there as Ping Giles gets up with a smile on her face. And the ball will go the other way. Personal foul on Stephanie McDonald. Ping Giles going to get a break, it looks like. Not sure I agree with that one. As Silvana Yez checks back in. Not sure I agree with taking off your top scorer when you're trying to come back, but there's a reason I'm sitting up there and Coach Carly Clark is sitting down there. So here's Mago, gives it to Yez. Down low. Oh, Yez wide open for three as Angela Tilk left her. Sokolov gets the board and Mago will reset for another go. Mago has all kinds of time. Wide open is Sokolov. The defense really hurting the GGs right now. Andy Sparks slams his bulletin board on the ground. Is all over his girls. And we will take a break. Gigi's up 14 with 4 minutes and 11 seconds left to play. GG's to inbound, down 14. We'll see what kind of pressure Ryerson's able to apply. Almost with the turnover. Gonna have to hurry to get the ball across right now. Stolen by the Rams, but we have an 8-second violation, and it will be Ryerson ball. So I hate to say it, but here come the Rams. See if they can do last night what they almost did to Carlton last night, too. The GG's tonight. Here's Mago takes it into the hands of Nunes. Here is Yez, throws it up, no good. She had a lane, she just took a funny angle at it and missed her layup. So the GG's bring it into the front court to try and burn some clock, maintain this lead. Here comes Ping Gill, she sets check back in on the next whistle. Bellimer Moya is Stephanie McDonald ran through all kinds of screens. Gonna fire up a three. No good, but rebounded by Maddie Steven. That's a backbreaker. Stephanie's open again. That time she hits. That's a big time shot by a big time player. GG's now have a 17-point lead. And just about any hope of a comeback should have been dashed by that three-pointer. And if the shot by Stephanie McDonald wasn't the dagger, that charge drawn by Julia Soriano will be, and I'm going to call this one a GG's victory, ladies and gentlemen. Foul is on Chloe Mago. That's her first, but that's the team's fifth. Normally you'd shoot a free throw on that, but you can't do that on an offensive foul, so the GG's will inbound. Stephanie McDonald's going to take a breather. Looks like she's cramping again or her knee's bugging her, one of the two. But she's done for the game, I would have to think. For Coach Andy Sparks to get as many of his starters out of there as he can in the next couple minutes. Betty Mermoyan miss. Rebound, Beslink. Up, good. 19-point lead for the GGs. Coach Andy Sparks knows he's got a game on Tuesday. I'm a little surprised he isn't clearing the bench right now. Spell these girls and get their legs fresh for Tuesday's big matchup. A lot of starters still on the court. Only one not out there is Stephanie McDonald and Angela Tilk. Here's Soriano bringing it into the front court. Nice look. Maddie Steven for two. And whatever Coach Andy Sparks said to his team in that timeout, they listened, and this game is over, folks. Here comes Kelly Ferran set to check in for the GGs. Scratch that. That is not Kelly Ferran. That is Sarah Van Hooydonk. So Sarah Van Hooydonk checks in, so that'll spell one more starter. The only two left on the court are Maddie Steven and Julia Soriano. Ping Gills, no good on both free throws, but rebounded by Nunes. Mago has it now. Minute 47 to play. Nice slip by Sokolov. She gets two. And Soriano will bring it up. Charlotte McKenzie brings it across. Into the hands of Soriano. Called for Beslink to go through, so she did. Beslink open in the corner. Gives it to Van Hooydonk. Fires up the three. First shot of the game. Maddie Steven has it now, and they're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow seemingly always favors the GGs and does once again. Now Kelly Ferran will check into the game. Yeah, now we're clearing the bench. Off comes Julia Soriano. Off comes Maddie Steven. In comes Sophie Briere. And we have, and this is Coach Andy Sparks saying, game's over, girls. Get ready for Tuesday when you will play the, at this point, 9-3 number one ranked Carleton Ravens. The GGs will move to 9-4 after tonight's game. We will wait the result of Carleton. See if I can find it in the next minute nine. See what the score is. Here's Charlotte McKenzie. Gets it up. No, off the back rim. And here comes Ping Giles. Up, no good. Rebounded, pushed around. Kelly Ferrand on the ground fighting for the ball. Jump ball, this one favors the... this one favors the Rams. And now we look like we have some new Rams coming into the game. So here is Gabrielle Robinson. Ping Giles gets it, puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Dee Domenico. That's her first time in the game. As that is Laura Gaskin putting it in. The rebound, my mistake, was rebounded by Shannon McHenry. Oh, here's Van Hooydonk open for three. No good. Gets her own rebound. And the girls can dribble this clock out for the most part. Kelly Ferran has it. They're just going to dribble around. It's back in Ferran's hands. Sorry, I'm trying to find a score for you folks, but it doesn't look like I'm going to. 3-2-1. Game over. GG's win. Nope, not quite. Spoke too soon. I did not do good math on that clock. That's the game. Well, I've been Joey Swarbrick. Gigi's win by 15. Gigi's move to 9-4. We'll see you Tuesday for more Gigi's women's basketball.